Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be in this day.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
My guests today are Pastor Daryl Gant, Eagles Nest, Sandusky, Ohio. Welcome. The Reverend Ella McDonald, Kingdom Building Ministries. Bettina Turner, the New Jerusalem Baptist Church, Pastor Curtis Johnson, and she's in song today. Let us pray.
Let us pray. Father God, as again we come with thanksgiving in our heart. We thank you for this day, for this is the day that you have made.
Thank you, Lord.
We shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes,
Father,
Lord.
We thank you for grace and mercy today.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we thank you because you have been so good to us. And we just come again and say thank you. Thank you for how you allowed us to come to do this program again today, Lord.
Yes.
Because we know without you, we wouldn't be able to come.
Thank
so
you,
we
Lord.
Give you praise and we give you thanks.
Thank
Father
you,
God,
Lord.
We ask you to bless those that have tuned in today, Lord. Somebody's asking for a blessing today, Lord. Somebody needs healing. Somebody needs deliverance, oh God.
Yes.
But you said, ask and it shall be given.
Thank you,
so Lord.
Lord,
we ask in the name of Jesus that you would touch lives today, Lord, that somebody's life will be changed and they will give their lives to you.
Mm-hmm.
Father, we thank you for Grace Cup,
thank
oh
you,
God.
Lord.
Father,
thank
we
you,
ask
Lord.
You to continue to bless in a mighty way.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we ask you to bless souls in convalescent home
thank
today,
you, Lord.
Lord. We ask you to bless those in the hospital today, Lord. Whatever they're going through today, we ask you to touch in the mighty
Lord,
name of
touch,
Jesus.
Lord.
Father,
you,
we
Lord.
Ask you to touch and bless the man of God
bless.
Who are going to bring the word today, Lord.
Yes.
Let somebody hear word today, Lord, so that they would turn their lives over to you. Father, we give you praise for the mighty works that you're going to do today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and thank God.
Amen
thank you, Lord.
And thank God.
Hallelujah.
Isn't it wonderful to be
Hallelujah.
Able to go to the throne of grace
Hallelujah.
And petition God?
Yes,
and know that he will answer. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Will you turn your Bibles to 1 Peter,
yes.
the 3rd chapter, 8 through 13. And it reads, verse 8, finally, be ye all one mind, mm-hmm. having compassion one to another, love as brethren, be pitiful, be courteous, mm-hmm. not rendering evil for evil mm-hmm. or railing for railing, but counterize blessing, knowing that ye are thereunto called that ye should inherit a blessing.
Yes.
Verse 10, for he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips they speak no guile.
Mm-hmm.
Let him endure evil and do good. Let him seek peace and endure it. For the eyes of the Lord are up over the righteous, and his ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil.
My God. My
13.
God.
Mm. And who is he that will harm you if ye be followers of that which is good?
Yes, yes.
Let's tune in to verse 12. But the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous,
mm-hmm.
and his ears are open unto their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil. Pray.
My God.
Pray.
Yes.
And now we will hear from Bettina Turner. I give myself away. Give yourself away to the Lord in prayer.
Hallelujah.
And after the song,
Amen.
You will hear from Pastor Gant.
Amen.
God bless you.
Thank you. myself away so you can use me. Here I am, here I stand, Lord, my life is in your hands. Lord, I long to see your desires revealed in. Give myself away so you can use me. Give myself away. Give myself away so you can use me. Take my heart, take my me. To you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. I give myself to you. I belong. I give myself.
Well, hello, everyone. It is an honor and a privilege to be on Grace Cup Ministries, and we're getting ready to dive in the Word of God, and we're going to start in Galatians, the book of Galatians, Galatians chapter 5. And this particular book, Paul is talking to the church in Asia Minor because people had crept into the church trying to get them to go back into some legalistic things or some religious order of things where truly our salvation is based upon Jesus dying on the cross for our sins. The Bible is very clear. In Ephesians, it says that we're saved by grace through faith. It is not of works, lest any man should boast, but it is the gift of God. And if someone gives you a gift, they give you a gift. For instance, if I have my watch and I said, you know what, I just want to bless you with this. And you say, thank you, and you receive it. Now, let me ask you a question. What did you do to earn it? You didn't do anything. The only thing that you did was receive what was already given to you. Well, salvation, which is in Christ Jesus, has been given to us, and it costs God everything because it costs him his son so that you and I can have a harmonious relationship with him. So if you have your Bibles, I'll be reading out of the New Living Translation. So it says in Galatians chapter 5, it says, so Christ has truly set us free. Now make sure that you stay free and don't get tied up again in slavery to the law. In other words, the Ten Commandments, which was given to the nation of Israel, and of course the Ten Commandments or the ordinance of God was a school teacher, a schoolmaster, to let us know that we have need of God. And so once Christ came, then therefore he fulfilled the law, and now we are no longer enslaved to the law, but we are able to hear from God and be led by his Spirit. And that is a wonderful thing. So I have a tendency to go backwards. So in Galatians 4 and 28, Paul says, now, my brothers and sisters, we are children of the promise, just like Isaac. But the children of the promise, he says, but you are now being persecuted by those who want you to keep the law. Just as Ishmael, the child that was born through human effort, persecuted Isaac, the child born by the power of the Spirit. Let's go backwards in verse 24. The two women serve as an illustration of God's two covenants. In other words, the Old Testament and New Testament, the first covenant, the second covenant. He says the two women serve as an illustration of the two covenants. The first woman, Hagar, represents Mount Sinai, where people received the law and it enslaved them. And now Jerusalem, like Mount Sinai in Arabia, because she and her children live in slavery to the law. But the other woman, Sarah, represents the heavenly Jerusalem. So is the free woman, and she is as our mother. And of course, the women representing, in a sense, God's covenant with the people of God and so forth and so on. And so he's talking about Isaac, who was born by a promise. Sarah couldn't have a son, but God gave Abraham a promise. And you and I are saved by grace. We're saved because of what God has done, not because you and I have to qualify for it. And that's what makes the gospel the greatest message on the face of the planet. God loves you and I. So, ladies and gentlemen, no matter who you are, what you're doing, God loves you. And the very thing that has caused a heartache or trouble or a problem in your life, he has already given the antidote for it. And what he wants us to understand is that the government is not the answer. Politicalness is not the answer. Your checking account or your bank account is not the answer. It's not what mom and dad said. Your freedom is in Christ Jesus. Now, so he tells the church at Asia Minor, he says, so Christ has truly set us free. Now, don't be enslaved again. Well, the first question you may ask is, what did he free me from? Well, since we're all sons of Adam and Eve, and our foreparents had disobeyed God. As a result, the children also, who had nothing to do with anything, were born into sin also, because we were the offspring of our parents. And so as a result, God says, wow, you know, it's not the way I originally intended to be. But what I'll do, I'll take care of that issue. And so he came down himself. He came down, his only begotten son, that he would bear our sins. And the Bible is very clear in Romans 3:21, for all have sinned and come short of the knowledge of God. In other words, we are all guilty. But even when we were guilty, the Bible says Christ died for us. Why would God do such a thing? Well, ladies and gentlemen, he did it because he was in love with us. And the Bible is very clear. We are made in his image and in his likeness. I want to read something to you that I got in my prayer devotion. It says, my Father's intense love, talking about Father God, for me, or for you and I, have granted us great riches of mercy. His desire for fellowship and intimacy. We were created for his pleasure and to glorify him for his kindness towards us, to reflect his person to a lost world of pain and hurt, to remind them of their true origin. Ladies and gentlemen, your true origin, you were born from above. Your parents was a vehicle that God has used to get you here upon the earth to make you legal. And in order to be legal upon the earth, you have to have a what? Earth suit. And your body is an earth suit. But the real you is not the one you see in the mirror. The real you is your spirit, and you have a soul, which is your mind and your intellect. So as I was saying, to remind you and I of our true origin, and that you and I are free to serve God without limits, no longer a slave to sin and self. In other words, there's no alcoholic that when he took the first drink that decided that I want to be a drunk. There's no person that has a promiscuous and how they live decided that I just want to sleep with everybody. In other words, sin is enticing and it is enslavement. And God loves us so much, ladies and gentlemen, that he has already destroyed the power of sin, that you and I will no longer be held captive to poverty, sickness and disease, torment, mental torment. And we hear about the recession and the things that are happening in our world today and men's heart failing them for fear. Ladies and gentlemen, God wants you to know that he will be with you. He just wants you to call upon him. And his name is Emmanuel, God with us, Christ Jesus the Lord. And he wants linking up with his plans and purposes in Christ in the heavenly realms. And our authority and power is delegated in him. So, ladies and gentlemen, we see in the word here that Paul says in verse 5, he says, but we who live by the Spirit eagerly wait to receive by faith the righteousness God has promised to us. For when we place our faith in Christ Jesus, come on, ladies and gentlemen, say that with me, in Christ Jesus, not in my bank, not in my money, not in my employer, and in Christ Jesus, that there is no benefit between circumcision and uncircumcision. But what is important is faith, which works by love. In other words, true freedom is walking in the love of God and God placing himself in us. And the Bible says in 1 John that God is love. And the love that God wants to reach and begin to change the world is one person at a time. And he wants you to know more than anything else, he has already delivered you from the thing that you continue to stumble on. Ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't matter what it is. You belong. Don't believe the lie. Don't believe the hype. For those that have been rejected, words that have been spoken to you that you'll never amount to this, you'll never amount to that, it's a lie from the gates of hell. God has already set you free from other people's rejection. Hallelujah. Because when Jesus was on that cross, the things of rejection that would come against us, he has already bore it. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be hurting in your physical body. And the doctor says, well, there's nothing we can do. Well, the Bible says that Jesus, God, in the Acts chapter 10, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about what? Doing good, delivering all that was what? Oppressed by the devil. In other words, God has a plan to touch your body and to heal you. And people say, well, no, that's not true. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if it wasn't God's will to heal people today, then why would Jesus heal people? Jesus would have been out of the will of the Father. So he said, I only do what my Father say do. So it is the will of God that you be healed, ladies and gentlemen. Why would God? Because he loves us, ladies and gentlemen. If it's not out of love, it's not coming from the kingdom of heaven. It's not from the kingdom of our God. And are you saying, Pastor Darrell, are you saying that we can just do anything because God loves us? Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible is clear. In Romans chapter 1, it says, may we continue in sin that grace may abound? Absolutely no. The truth of the matter is, I don't know about you, but have you ever had ketchup? Do you like ketchup on your sandwiches? And some people say, oh, I love ketchup. Well, let me ask you a question. When you squeeze the ketchup bottle, there's no mustard that's going to come out. Absolutely not. Well, when you're born of God's Spirit and the Spirit of God lives in you, then the way of sin, the sinful lifestyle will no longer be, you won't be comfortable doing it like that. In other words, the same way mustard won't come out of a ketchup bottle, when you're in Christ and he lives inside of you, well, guess what? The things you used to do will no longer have the same taste that it used to have. So the answer that you and I have been looking for and searching for, we've been looking for love in all the wrong places. And God is saying, hey, hey, hello, I'm here. Will you just give me a try? I'll never reject you. I'll never push you away. This is your time. This is your season. My son has already he has already provided your freedom. And so he's telling the church, don't allow yourself to be entangled with the rules and regulations of man. Be ye steadfast where Christ has made us free. And he says here, dear brothers and sisters, he says, for if you have been called to freedom, my brothers and sisters, in verse 13, don't use your freedom to satisfy your sinful nature. Instead, use your freedom to serve one another. Hallelujah. Why does God make us free? So we can be a blessing to someone else. For the whole law can be summed up in this one command: love your neighbor as you love yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, you might say, well, I don't love myself. Well, it starts with this, receiving God's love for you. And when you know how much, and you begin to realize how much God loves you, then you'll be able to love yourself and you'll be able to love others. And the only thing that you have to qualify to receive his love is nothing but receive it, okay? It says now, verse 15, but if you have always, and he warns us, don't bite and devour one another. Watch out that you may destroy one another. In verse 16, the reason why we don't bite and devour one another is because God got enough for everybody. Okay. We don't have time to be jealous. We don't have none of that because God loves us right where we are. You know what I'm saying? He don't love the Pope any less than he loves the small man. In other words, he loves us all the same. We were created in his image and his likeness. And I want to say to you, if I said the word Pope, I didn't mean anything by it, okay? All right, let's keep going. And so he says, verse 16, so I say, let the Holy Spirit guide your life. Then you won't be doing what your sinful nature desires. And ladies and gentlemen, what that is saying is very simple. God says, hey, in order to live a godly life, you first have to have me inside of you. That's the first thing. It's impossible to live a righteous life without the God of righteousness. And so he has already made provisions that he can live inside of you. and all you have to do is receive it. So he says, and to my brothers and sisters that are already in Christ, we understand that there is a war between our old nature and the new nature. And it says in 17, the natures battle with one another, but we are led by the Spirit. And so he's very clear. He says that which we put our mind to, that's the one we begin to yield to. That's a whole different message, okay? But ladies and gentlemen, I just want to share some notes. It says God's justice reigns. The law of the Spirit world has been established. So God wants you and I to understand that even when we are unable to visibly see it, it doesn't mean that the motions have not taken place. And so if the little bit of this message has been a blessing to you, I want you to please contact Grace Cup. Now, the Bible is very clear. It says that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And if you're here listening to me right now, it doesn't matter. God loves you. I want you to cry out to Jesus. Say, Lord Jesus, I heard the message and I feel something in my heart. And I ask you to come into my life and be Lord of my life. I welcome you. I need you. If you have received the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, he has come into your heart and he has promised he'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you and he'll be with you even until the end of the age. So I want to exhort you to find a Bible believing church, fill it of the Spirit, or make sure you write or call or contact Grace Cup Ministries and let them know that you received the gospel message and you were blessed by the ministry message. God bless you. Thank you. Until we meet again. Amen.